quickly about some superhero video games because I do want to wrap up the night with some Mr. King here. So let's go down to a little ugly kid Joe, and this goes out to everyone out there that's listening. Everything I hate about you here on Chuckles Crypt.
Are you the guys radio on the beach who hate everything? Is this some sort of hip music that I don't understand?
Song is dedicated to every one of you little cheating bastards that like to camp out in those video games and waste countless times and make it so ancient geezers like myself do not have fun on this thing called the internet. And that's out to you. especially when you swear at me when I don't know how to push the buttons to the game. Come on, I'm from Nintendo, all right? Our biggest accomplishment was beating the game. We didn't care about a flipping trophy we got. Now, if you told me you beat Goonies 2, I would pat you on the back because that is an accomplishment I've never heard anybody say. But when you tell me you got a trophy for making 16 headshots on whatever it is, Saints Row or whatnot.
Your own head.
Yeah, I am not impressed, and neither are the ladies, guys. So posting those up on Facebook, not going to get you the ladies.
Chuckle, speaking of beating games and not beating games, is it only an urban legend, or was there actually one or two games that were unbeatable for some reason? In other words, like they were actually programmed wrong or the code was written wrong?
I don't know. As far as I know about that, Pac-Man was considered unbeatable, wasn't it? Like it would just recycle.
Well, it was endless.
Right, but I think I'm thinking more along the lines of like story games. Like there was a Raiders of the Lost Ark game. I forget, maybe on Nintendo, maybe somewhere else. But in other words, like if you followed the clue, in other words, you couldn't resolve the game. In other words, you couldn't solve it.
There's a possibility. I've never actually played games like that where there was no ending to it that there was meant to be.
Right, there was meant to be, but there wasn't, in
right.
other words.
I there could be something out there like that. And the listeners, if you know, put it out there. And next time we talk on video games, we'll brush a little bit about one of a favorite topic of ours is E.T. So when we come back, we will be doing a part two to the video game sess. I think it has to be done. But I'm going to wrap things up with my list of my top favorites. So in case you nerds are out there are wondering, what does the clown play on the video game systems? Now, first of all, I'm not very picky about the video game systems. If the controller fits in my hand, I like the game. If the buttons aren't complicated, I like the game. Top 10, Air Raiders, Activision. Everybody remembers that game. Lots and lots of time wasted on that. Number 9, Saints Row 3. You can't go wrong with running down gangsters inside of modded cars or blowing people up with tanks. Number 8, Pac-Man. Yeah, so many dollars and coins wasted on that machine, and I grew up in the Pac-Man era, so of course, that's one of my favorites. Number 7, Star Wars Battlefront. And if you're a Star Wars nerd, Battlefront 3 is on its way. Number 6, Twisted Metal. Now, that's the system that got me into, or the game that got me into the PlayStation, running over dogs and people to get you life, mowing down people in vehicles, very Mad Max-ish. And you could tell that that guy that probably created that game had a lot of inspiration from Mad Max. Number 5, need I say more, Assassin's Creed. I don't need to explain why that's one of my favorite games, do I? Number 4, Army Men, Sarge's Heroes. Who doesn't like playing with Army Men?
Absolutely.
Yeah, especially when you're an old guy, and buying Army Men at the toy store is a little creepy. So buying a video game where you could play the Army Men, not as creepy.
Plus the cats chew the heads off.
Yeah. Number 3, an all-time favorite of mine, Q-Bert. As frustrating as that game was, I loved it. I don't think I ever got out of the fifth level because it got too hard and too quick, but I loved it. Number 2, Mortal Kombat. And yes, that game wasted a lot of my time, not as much as Doom, but a lot of my time and a lot of my money on controllers, video game systems, and extra disc. You're welcome there, sir. I gave you a little extra cash there. And of course, I told you earlier, number 1 was Doom. And yes, the newer Doom I liked a lot. So the original is still my favorite. Now, if you're out there and you're wondering, are there any video games that they made for comic books? Well, of course there is. And there's a lot of them. But I'm going to give you a couple that you might enjoy. George, don't pick any of these up because you'll lose your life.
Okay.
Now, recently, Disney Infinity for the Xbox One or the 360 was just released. And that's all about Avengers, Spider-Man, Guardians of the Galaxy. Really cool.
It's a fun
game to play. Nurse Misery and I have wasted lots of time in there playing Thor and Hulk and beating each other across the screen. Definitely entertaining.
And we can play together. That's the bonus part.
Yeah, Aliens 3. Anybody remember this from Sega Genesis? That was a flipping hard game, but it was awesome. This creature's wearing a queen. What the hell is that noise down there?
That's
messed up.
That's fun.
Yeah. Number 8, Batman Arkham Asylum for the 360, an awesome game, and breathed life into a lot of Batman that a lot of people were starting to lose. Aliens, Colonial Marines. Anybody remember this one? Yeah.
I do, yes. Actually, yes.
It was out for the arcade. They released it again for the 360. Pretty interesting game. The Incredible Hulk, the 360 one. You can't go wrong with that. Destroying, throwing cars, throwing people off buildings. Awesome. Injustice, created by the creators of Mortal Kombat. DC characters fighting each other.
That one was fun.
That was a lot of fun.
They even beat you.
Yeah, they ripped you off, though, with that. They really did. That's another story for another day. And my all-time favorite superhero game came out for the Sega Genesis, and it was the Avengers, where the last villain you fought was the Red Skull on top of the plane. I love that game. I wasted a lot of time sitting there as Vision going through it because he was the one that was the easiest to beat everybody with. And I didn't try any other characters because I would lose. Now, there are a couple out there that are pretty bad. And I'm going to say this right now. Normally, if they release a video game for a movie, it's going to suck. Just keep that in mind, folks. As much as you're going to pick that up and say, this is awesome, I got the video game for Iron Man 2, guess what? That thing is horrible. Don't do it. You'll break a controller. Trust me. Superman. I have not found a Superman game that is entertaining.
They can't really make too many Superman movies that are entertaining either.
No, and this is a problem because Superman, it's awesome. If you're out there listening, game creators, this should not be hard to make an awesome Superman video game.
I think they should make a Superman video game set in the George Reeves 50s TV show world.
Anything. It's not hard to make this.
Well, obviously it is.
And, of course, one of the biggest letdowns to me, Aliens versus Predator. When it finally came out for the system, horrible. Horrible. So, now, if you guys want to listen to more of this, I believe that when we come back in about a week after Memorial Day, which, by the way, evil Memorial Day to everybody out there, we come back, we'll have a part two to this. I think it needs to be done. There's a lot to the video game world
we only touched on superhero video games.
Exactly.
Right. And there is a lot of stuff out there to touch on. We're going to leave, though, go out with some Mr. King here, B.B. King. And yes, and some of these games has done this to me. The thrill is gone. Here on Chuckles Crypt, Rhode Island Free Radio, stay tuned for the Haunted Cabaret.
The thrill is gone.